Everyone can generate stunning AI images, even turn them into videos. But shaping those random visuals into something with rhythm, emotion, or a message, that's what separates random content from real storytelling. And I've got to say, OpenArt's new Stories feature really gets it right. You can create full videos like character vlogs, stories, or music videos from just a simple idea. It takes care of everything in the background, visuals, music, and animation. In the next few minutes, I'll show you exactly what you can create and how it all works. So let's dive in. This video is made possible by OpenArt. We appreciate them for building tools that actually help creators. All right, first, head over to the OpenArt website. You'll find the link right at the top of the description. On the left-hand side, you'll see a new feature called One-Click Story. Click on that, and you'll get four options: character vlog, music video, explainer video, and start from scratch. Let's start with character vlog, and it's super simple. All right, so this is the interface, and here you will see these pre-made characters. You can either pick one from the list or upload your own. I'm going to upload mine, this cute fluffy monster I made, and I'm naming him Globnor, and then I'll hit create. Next, add a vlog topic. For this one, I'll type Globnor driving to the beach, having a picnic, surfing, enjoying good food, and watching the sunset. Basically, just write what your character is going to do in the video. Keep it simple and visual. Next, for the aspect ratio, I'm going with 16:9. We also have an option to add background music. If you've generated a track using Suno, you can paste the link here, or just upload a file from your computer. Once you select the music, you'll see this interface. Now, at the moment, OpenArt only supports 1 minute of audio, but they've mentioned that longer durations are in the works. So just select the part of the music you want to use in the video, then hit confirm. I'm not adding any music for now, since I'm saving that part for editing later. Moving on to advanced settings. This is where you choose the image and video models. For images, we've got the Flux models and also a ChatGPT-based model. Personally, I've gotten the best results using Flux Context, especially when working with characters. The GPT model sometimes changes the visual style randomly. Like if you start with a realistic frame, it might suddenly switch to an illustrated one. That makes it harder to keep things consistent. So for this project, I'm sticking with Flux Context. For video, there are several models to choose from, but I usually go with Kling AI's model. It consistently gives me better results. Once you've set everything, just hit Create Story. Now it'll take a couple of minutes, around 2 to 3 minutes, to generate all the assets. All right, here's the final result.
We packed the sky in a basket, took a ride down to the shore. Globnor's dancing by the blanket, like we've done this all before. Sun's out, waves talk.
Honestly, I really like how this turned out. Now, let me show you how you can edit your video. Head over to the My Story section and hover over the project you want to edit. You'll see a little pen icon, click on it, and it'll open up the project in a timeline editing interface. Now, just head over to the Storyboard tab to start fine-tuning your scenes. On the left side, you'll see the Image section, and on the right, the Video section. Each block will show the prompt that was used to generate the assets. As you can see, I've already tested this and regenerated a few images and clips. Now, let's say you get an inaccurate image and want to regenerate it. Just click the retry button. It'll generate a new image using the same prompt. If you want more control, you can also modify or completely change the prompt. Just make sure to tag your character, type at, and select their name. You'll also notice that the phrase pink convertible is surrounded by double angle brackets, like this. That's used to maintain consistency of objects across images. For example, in the next frame, the same pink convertible is mentioned the same way, and you'll notice the car looks nearly identical. And the same thing happens in the next few scenes, like this blue surfboard with a flower-like design. It shows up again, almost identical in both images. Now, OpenArt hasn't officially mentioned this technique, but if you want to keep specific objects looking the same across different images, just wrap them in double-angle brackets. It really helps with consistency. Once you've written a new prompt, you can choose a different image model. This time, you can try the GPT models, since the prompt is now under your control. Just keep in mind, they cost significantly more than Flux Context. For example, GPT High gives you the best quality, but it costs 100 credits per image, while Flux Context only costs 5 credits. After selecting your model, just click Retry to generate a new image. Once you've got your updated image, you can move on to regenerating the video. The process is similar. Select a video model, update the prompt, and click Retry. Here, you don't need to tag your character or objects. Just keep the prompt simple and precise. That's it. You'll get a brand new video based on the updated image and prompt. If you want to add a new scene between two existing ones, just click the plus icon. This will give you a new block where you can either imagine a new scene from scratch or upload assets from your PC. Now, if you switch back to the timeline interface, you'll see the option to add music or voiceover. Click the music icon and you'll be able to upload a track from your computer. I already have my music ready, so I'll just drag it into the timeline. On the right-hand side, you'll see some basic audio controls. If you want to trim the music, just drag the edges of the audio clip to select the exact part you want to use. And once everything's set, just click share and then download your video. All right, now let's check out another cool feature, music video. Click on it, and this is the interface. The first thing you'll do is upload your music file. And again, you're limited to 1 minute, so pick the best part of your track and hit confirm. Now you'll see three different modes, style, story, and sing. Let's start with style mode and see how it works. All right, so here you can choose from a set of preset styles. And honestly, that's what I recommend. You can also write your own style prompt, but when I tried it, things got weird. So in my style prompt, I included VHS texture, and because of that, it kept generating VHS tape visuals throughout the video. Here's what I got.
Cracks in the pavement, jagged and wide. Every step a gamble, nowhere to hide. Street lights flicker like they're about to die.
And here's what the result looks like when you stick to the default style presets. So yeah, I think sticking with the presets is your best bet. And just like before, in all the modes, you can choose your image and video models too. All right, now we have story mode. First, you'll see Auto Story. This takes your lyrics and builds a story-based music video around them. Super easy. Then there's One Star Story. This one lets you pick a character or upload your own from your computer. You also get a story topic box. If your lyrics don't match the visuals you want, you can type in your own idea here. The AI will create a custom script based on your topic. I tried this with my character Globnor and a song I made using Suno AI. I didn't use a prompt because my lyrics already told the story. Here's what it came out like.
Is that a fair? Oh, yeah, it is. Globner's off to Fluffington Fair, bouncing round without a care. Cotton candy pies that fly. Chaos reigns when Globner's nearby.
So as you saw, we can generate some pretty amazing music videos with this feature. Now, let's move to the next one. Sing mode. This one lip syncs your uploaded character to the music. I uploaded a rock track and used this character image, and here's what the result looked like.
Cracks in the pavement, jagged and wide. Every step a gamble, nowhere to hide. Street lights flicker like they're about to die.
Pretty cool, right? This is the kind of stuff you can create using the music video feature. Finally, we have the explainer video option. Here's what the interface looks like. This mode is designed to create voiceover-driven AI videos. On the left, you've got a text box. Just type a topic like 5 popular dishes in Europe, and the AI will automatically generate a script based on it. But if you already have your own voiceover script and you want it to stay exactly as you wrote it, make sure to turn off the auto-polish toggle. Otherwise, it'll rewrite parts of your script automatically. Then you can choose a visual style for your images, or add a custom style. And here, custom styles actually work really well. You can write style prompts just like you would in any other image generation tool. Next, pick a voice actor from the available options, and the rest is pretty much the same as before. Here's a quick example of a video I created using this tool.
This is 2077. The world didn't die, it rebooted. Water comes in pills, air in rented tanks. We haul oxygen bags like pay-as-you-go, lungs beneath synthetic skies. Forests are rumors, sunlight costs by the hour. Most people burrow in echoing tunnels lit by broken neon, while armored giants patrol the surface.
As you can see, these videos are genuinely impressive for something built in just one click. And if you don't want to rely on presets, you can use the start from scratch option. It's perfect for building custom stories or delivering a message with your own visuals and ideas. So go check the link in the description and start making your own stories. If this video helped you out, drop a like and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one.